Okay, take three. That's the Potter's wheel or pottery wheel machine. It's a miniature portable version that I'm gonna show you a little bit. I got this pottery machine. That's the model voltage Guocheng, and that's the power button that says probably the same thing in Chinese. This is from China. I think it's bought from eBay. I got it from, it's some kind of metallic cover in the Team Mystic colors or Finnish colors, white and blue, the Finland's flag colors. And here's the clay covered measuring tape, and I'm gonna show you that the main plate on this thing is about, I think it's about 25 centimeters, give or take. The halkaisia or whatever we call it, diameter or something. And the whole thing is probably, I just can't put it up there, but it's probably like 35-ish. I can't do it with just one hand, sorry. And there's the speed adjuster, which is kind of like, we call it Pauline. This is kind of like a, kind of like the, you get a little bit of heads up of the size. It's as kind of like a small one, and there's the height of the pool. I think it's about 7.5 centimeters, and then the, of course you can put. Hopefully it didn't show something tragical. There's a lot of, this is like my lap that's full of garbage everywhere. Junk, just everywhere. Garbage and junk. There's a couple of centimeters tall before it goes to the over the edge, and then I mean, this is a potter's wheels machine, so you might put water in here if you start rolling pottery clay on this thing. It's some kind of thick metal, and this is the, there you can see the adjustment gear goggles. This is what you use to adjust the spinning power on this thing. And then it basically goes to right or left, and here you put the power on. It shows a light in here that you can't see because I'm using the light, but let's try this way. So now we could basically put something on it and roll it by using this thing. So let's try. I noticed that this is somehow, it's gotten somehow stuck. So let's see. Now if we press this thing like it's some kind of game controller on driving game. Oh shit. By the way, it's trying to fall over, but anyway. If you press this, then you can spin stuff on it. And it should kinda spin faster or slower based on how much you press it. But it seems to be kind of cracking now. I don't know. It's somehow gotten a little bit stuck. Maybe the quality is not so good. I haven't even used this yet, so hopefully it doesn't break down before I use it. Lol. But if you press this to the other way, of course, then you can spin it the other way around. Only thing it's doing basically, potter's wheel, it only spins the clay on this. So you can spin it, then you can form something like a cup or a plate that looks identical on the both side, and you can just use the water in here or the clay to form like maybe the Chalice of Souls from medieval games. That's one of the ideas that I would want to do with this kind of thing. Only thing it does, it spins the clay and makes it identical when you can now hold it and just kind of like use the super duper sound effects to sculpt that shit. And then I'm gonna put the power on, I mean off, and let me see, I'm gonna switch this shit over. Just gonna put that shit so that you can see what's up in this. So basically when I ordered this thing, It's some kind of metal, and you can also adjust these legs. There's some kind of bolt on the other side, so you can, if it doesn't, it keeps creaking and doesn't stay steady, then you can just roll these up and forth. And when I ordered these things, it was this block here, this engine, was basically, it was basically knit together with these, we call it nippuside. I don't know what this thing is, but it had a lot of nippuside around here, but all of them have broken down apart in the delivery, so it was basically kind of like hanging on here. I have to remove those things, broken things, and then I put some pink fairy colored aluminium wire in here. So I basically put it together with the aluminium wire that I use for sculpting also. But these are basically like some kind of simple. I don't know, does this thing actually spin while it's using it? But if you use water in here, you might want to watch that the water doesn't leak down. I don't know how well it is insulated. If the water drops down and breaks the engine, then you might be in trouble, but this is also some kind of metallic part. And then there's some kind of connection wires that have those weird things that they go, and then they go into that kind of thing and just continue from it. I don't know, I haven't seen this kind of things on the typical Finnish electronics. And I guess this thing is the engine that makes it spin. And then there's some kind of thing that looks like a driving wheel here. I think it might be connected to the spinning thing. I can't really see exactly how it is functioning, but it's falsely filled with nothingness. And that thing is just holding it there. It's pretty simple. And only thing it does, it spins the wheel. It doesn't do anything else, so you can't really expect much. And I am holding this camera thing, this leg thing, so I can't really show you anything clear. But it's pretty simple. The direction adjustment, and there's the light, and there's the power, and there's the wire that goes to the electric input, and it has that slip knot on it. And also this one has, so basically if you try to rip out the wire, it's gonna get stuck on that one end, so it doesn't break the wires. But this really still isn't really good for that. But you might wanna watch that you don't pull these things. But you can use this kind of like a washing machine leg so that you can kind of balance the thing. And I measured that this machine weighs about 9.6 kilograms, almost 10 kilos. So it's inverted 69, so that's kind of cool. And it goes to that wire over there, and there's nothing else. And let me see one thing. The previous video, I forgot to mention something. So this is a continuation of the Christmas video, so I'm gonna turn this thing around. So this is kind of like as cheap and a small Potter's wheel that you can get. So I'm gonna show you the Sylvian from the previous video compared to the Potter's wheel. So that's the sizing of the Sylvian, and I forgot to mention that the Sylvian probably weighs about, let's see, how much it. I don't have a measurement for less than 1 kilogram, so this is probably around 300-ish grams, so 0.3 kilograms or something like that, just by guessing. I don't know the exact measurement, but anyway, it's just a guess. There's my tiger match rest, and here's some related things to this thing. That there's some kind of handmade clay sculpture figures that I made in the year 2002. Handmade out of modeling clay. These are about the size of a Dungeons and Dragons figure. And they're Christmas related, so that's why I wanted to show them. These are basically 21 plus years old, made in 2002, but this is like the most more original version. It's a snowman ogre. It's my idea was to use these things as some kind of grid-based D&D type of strategy game. It's almost like a MOBA game before MOBA was invented, because Warcraft 3 invented MOBA, basically with the mods. And they are basically made before MOBA was invented. But anyway, this is like some kind of like a... It's basically like the two-headed ogre from Warcraft 3. And this is like some kind of Warcraft 3 hero unit also. But they were supposed to be used as in kind of grid-based battle game. But anyway, I'm gonna show you that you can roll this. Oh shit, I didn't put the wire on. And does it work now? It doesn't, unless you put this one on. Yeah, now you can spin it. And you can see that you could sculpt stuff with this. And now it actually spins quite fast if you put the max speed. So that's not exactly the speed that you would want. You want to put some kind of slower piece. Maybe this kind of thing. But it does have different speeds if it's working correctly. Then you just put it there and off. And there's a button also here. I don't know what this button does. I haven't pressed it, but I think it might be the self-destruction sequence for Umbrella Corporation. If you wanna blow up the whole house with this, it has like a 13.37 second cooldown, so it's gonna blow up the house in that time. That's just a joke, by the way. But on the other side, there's pretty much nothing. It's just painted. It has some kind of splash over painting here. It looks like it's melting a little bit, but it's basically nothing except some kind of just blank nothingness. And from that Sylveon sizing, you can basically see what the size of this thing is. My Sylveon is actually bigger than this thing. So yeah. I can also show you the measurement. Oh shit. It's actually showing more garbage on the background, but this is my creepy Dankenstein laboratory, so it's filled with garbage anyway. You can see the measurement. It's all junk everywhere. Paper, trash, and it doesn't show the correct sizing, sorry. But you can get a little bit of heads up. If I link this information to the inventory, you can see a better sizing of it. But it's a really good idea that I might use later on to do some kind of sculpture and stuff. So this cost about 120-ish euros or something with postal fees. I don't know what else to say about it except that it's really good and you might want to get one. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for more and Merry Christmas and stuff.